Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bastion Slot. We are back building our Planet Zoo franchise mode build. Today's video, we're not doing any new animals, but we are instead working on many different new facets of the zoo. We're going to add a new shopping cafe kind of area, we're going to add some displays, we're going to bring in those trees with the glass things, these right here, yes, that I was talking about in the last video. My throat is exploding, one moment. Okay, so we're all good. This is actually a fairly long time lapse. This is actually, if you put everything together, I think this is actually the longest build I've done in a very long time, if not ever. This is a times 9 speed time lapse, and it's still over 20 minutes. So it's about 3.5 hours worth of building. Now, I will admit, a lot of that was spent staring at Google images or not really having any idea whatsoever what I wanted to do. But that's not the point. I mean, that's part of building anyway, right? So what we're doing here is just like a little walkway. That's it, just a little fancy walkway, just to bridge the gap between the Pronghorn exhibit and the shopping area, and therefore wrapping back around to the Ghost of Black Rock and to the sort of the main park entrance sort of bit. I just wanted it to tie in and look nice with the rest of the park, but also to use those glass pillar thingamajiggies once again, just to kind of have them be a presence further on into the park. I really don't want them absolutely everywhere, and we're actually going to change them up style-wise a little bit to give them a little bit more of a modern twist and to make them look a little bit better, in my opinion. Quite a bit further on into this time-lapse. But, what was I saying? Important words, I'll tell you that for free. Yeah, so we just wanted to kind of extend it a little bit, don't want them everywhere, but I think if they're just in the exhibit, it looks a little bit odd. So this is a little walkway. We've got the angular sort of metal roof that we always have, and we're gonna do like a little bit of a glass water display, just like at the start of the park. You'll see me every now and again, zoo, not park, you'll see me every now and again kind of nip back to the start and have a little look at how I built it before, because I do want this to have the whole place have running themes and then individual little unique creative bits in each of those areas. That's kind of the idea. I'm sure I've mentioned that before. I really want to reuse a lot of the same textures, a lot of the same materials, a lot of the same colours. It's blacks, greys, browns, silvers. Basically, it doesn't sound that exciting when you put it like that. Do a little bit there. We're going to do like a little bit of garden there. You've got to keep the foliage in just to keep things interesting. Forgot to flatten the ground there, but that's okay. Just just working on making this bit look nice. Most of this video will be spent on the cafe. The cafe was definitely the big focus, and it does look pretty good by my own, admittedly. Yeah, I've decided not to be harsh on my building skills anymore. The cafe is pretty cool. Buildings are not my specialty, but I think it's pretty cool. That's all I will say on the matter. So I really wanted to make these a little bit more interesting, and I started to bring in this little design element. I say design element, it sticks, okay? but we're actually going to use this quite a lot in the cafe as well. So what I really like about this is kind of half the cafe, what it's leading up to, and also half the exhibit we just left, the Pronghorns, via the glass. It also makes it just have a little bit more of a natural feeling to it while still retaining that modern edge, which is very much the goal of the park. And it is a park, it's called Black Rock Park, god darn it. So, yeah, I'm just kind of replacing half of the glass with these wooden stick bits. And I think it's actually a big improvement. It makes it more interesting to look at, it brings in the wood, which is a common facet around the entire park, it maintains the glass, it still ties in with the Pronghorns, and it ties in even better with the cafe. It's all in all it's just good stuff, folks. It really, really is. I'm very talented. I was messing around the idea of sort of blocking off the top, but I think I decided against that. Stick a random thing on the wall. Can't go wrong with a random silver thing on the wall. What am I doing now? Let's see what I do. Oh yeah, so this is again the continuation. You're gonna see this a lot in the cafe. It actually ends up looking really cool. It's like quite a nice design feature. You know, it's wood, but it looks modern. I've got some plans to get a little bit funkier with it, but for now we're just gonna use it to block off parts of this and just make the design a bit more interesting. Here I'm just trying to get the water in. We're trying to get it nice and moist. It is raining in the background. We do have to hit play temporarily, unfortunately, because, well, I need to see where the water is, you know, what it's doing, kind of thing. Just trying to make sure it's not spilling out absolutely everywhere. The water is overly excited. It goes everywhere. It's okay. Just like the other roofs, we're going to have a little bit of a white, glowy stick just I haven't actually seen this area at night at all. I haven't got to nighttime yet, as I make this video, so I haven't done the lighting and stuff for most of it, so I'm quite excited about what that's gonna look. Had a little look, I found, so I had like this mood board containing tons of glass pieces, like modern glass art, and also some wooden art, but it wasn't quite working for me, so I went on Google and I picked up tons of images and I found this thing that I really like. Now we're gonna try it like this, I end up changing the whole thing, but it was basically this huge multi-layered glass block, kind of shattered, a little bit ragged, much more ragged than mine is here, and it had like a tree inside it. It was really cool, it looked amazing. I very quickly decided against that, it just wasn't working with the planets of glass, but we're doing this kind of cool, slightly modern art looking, floating glass display thing. Basically, it doesn't mean anything, it's not, you know, specific to anything, it's just meant to look like a modern piece of artwork with plants that are relevant to, you know, North America and everything like that. So just gonna build it, basically. I think it's kind of cool. This is just the kind of little thing I think you need just hanging around the park. It doesn't need to be a big centerpiece, it doesn't need to be a big focus, it just needs to pop up. You know, you walk around the corner and it's there, and you look at it for a few seconds, you think, hey, that's pretty cool, and then you're done. You just walk away at that point. Just putting some stuff at the sides to make sure it looks like it's actually, you know, physically possible for it to exist, and also giving it a little bit of a stand at the bottom. You'll see this in a little bit more detail in the build at the end, although I don't focus on it, it must be said. But that's about it, folks. It's just plants behind a glass sheet, essentially. I mean, it's pretty cool. Not a big dealio. But again, another theme I might want to take going forward. I think it's got potential. Imagine like a whole wall in the same style. I think it could look really, really cool. Also doing a little bit of a new fence style here, using, again, the wooden sticks. Papa loves his wooden sticks, as you will see. And gonna use this fence style quite a few times as well. It's a little bit more work, it must be said, which I'm against, generally speaking, but it does, I think, make a fairly positive difference to... I think just having something custom, custom built, even if it's just this little fence bit here, shut up world, really does do a lot for your park. It really does make a difference. I'm gonna put wood down here, I'm gonna get rid of it. No wood allowed, not in my house. Yeah, I think it's important. So now starts the cafe, and I had some problems here. So we're gonna do like a metal outline, and then the problem really was I wanted this metal base, but I wanted the glass and wood that's going to sit inside the metal to kind of not sit on the edge, but to sit sort of quite deep into it. So the metal kind of sticks out from the rim, right? As you'll see here, I've kind of customized it and pulled it in separately into a separate group. The problem with that then is that nothing quite sticks together in the way that it should. You know, I've kind of screwed it up from the get-go on purpose, admittedly, but still. So there's a lot of finagling, a lot of taking things out of the group like that, and then putting them back in, and then moving around, stuff like that. But we're just doing a nice little indoor cafe slash information center sort of shebang. I actually really struggle with this. I've been trying to do this little shopping area for quite a while. It was meant to be a video probably before the Pronghorns even. I actually gave it a little go. I just couldn't get it to work. There was something about it. It wasn't clicking. I wasn't having any big ideas. Like, how do I make this an interesting cafe? How do I make this an interesting eating area? Information, blah, 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 blah. And I think what my problem was, what I was doing is putting down the buildings, like these little, you know, facilities, and then putting the building around them, rather than building a building and then putting the facilities in the building, which is definitely the way to do it. I have a cold. Oh god, I need to sleep as well. I've been awake for many days. I don't know, not that long, like 20 hours or something, nothing too crazy. Yeah, so the path was, obviously you can't put these down on a path, unfortunately, so it was a small problem going on here, but managed to work around that pretty okay. We're gonna end up putting walls and stuff along there. So we've got a food shop, a drink shop, and an information center. That's all we're gonna do in here. I would have liked to add a restroom, now that I think about it, but I think it's a bit tight. Now, one thing I've really wanted to do for a long time is do a floating glass roof, and that's what we're gonna do now. So I was putting the wood down because that's what we're gonna use, but it's better to make the roof first, I think, and then go from there. And the idea is to You're not going to do that best in slots, so get rid of the bloody triangle. I'm going to stack those together a little bit more. Nope, we're just doing like a straight shape. And the idea is for it to curve a little bit. It's going to curve, it's going to float. Nothing too fancy, but just a little bit of a statement piece, a little bit of creativity in the roof to make the whole building look a little bit more interesting. So just do some rotating, take your little glass rectangles, move them along, get that nice and even. Oh, we're doing one more. Cheeky. Grab them all. Just make that. Yep, triple it up. Grab them all very slowly and just make sure they're sitting nice and perfectly in the middle. Like so. Good stuff. Now there is going to be quite a little bit of jumping, quite a little bit. That makes no sense whatsoever. There's going to be some jumps now and again. I really struggled with this build. I kept stopping and thinking, you know what, that'll do. I'll just upload it to YouTube as it is. I think I stopped like now. I was thinking, it's close enough. I think I did like 5 more times today. But every time I stopped, this unfinished, and it's not 100% finished, but it's definitely much, much closer than I thought it was going to be. Every time I stopped, it felt bad. You know, I felt like I have to, even if it's going to take a couple hours longer than I intended, maybe. You know, at the end of the day, I'm uploading this for you guys at home. I want this to be interesting. I want to end up with something cool at the end of the day. So I kind of just, like, as soon as I logged off Planet Zoo, I just had this sudden burst of guilt. I thought, you know, I'll just bloody log back on again and just log back on and log back on and log back on several times until eventually I ended up with something I was pretty happy with. So again, we're bringing in the wood. Love a bit of wood. Bringing in the wood just to, again, make sure the roof makes sense, basically. I didn't want it to be too imposing, because I want the roof to have this kind of slightly levitating. I mean, it doesn't look like it's floating, it looks like it's supported by the wood. But you can see through it, you know, it's hanging above where the rest of the roof will be, it's hanging above where the rest of the building is. It's just a little bit more interesting, basically. It's fancy, that is. It's fancy. Yeah. I like it, it looks cool, alright. So I'm gonna put a normal roof on there as well. Hate that corner piece with a passion. Does not want to. It just doesn't work. It doesn't fit with everything else for reasons I can't figure out. It's very upsetting for anyways. Yeah, so actually we're only about halfway through this. We've got about 11 minutes left. And it is 100% now focused on this cafe. The cafe, there's a lot of staring at nothing. Like I said, a lot of figuring things out, you know, what the hell do I want to do? But the cafe does kind of get to come alive in the next 10 minutes or so. But for now, we're just going to finish off the roof. The cafe doesn't literally come alive. That would be goddamn terrifying. But yeah, it's gonna end up looking quite a lot cooler by the end when I stop giving up on the bloody thing. Just adding the pathing in there. We've got 3 different entrances. 2 of them are directly opposite each other. I'd say the one on the right that you can't really see around here is the main entrance, but it could be either of these two. Then there's more like a side entrance back on the other way where you come in from the Pronghorns and stuff like that. I don't know, that doesn't really matter. Right, yeah, that's the basic shell of the cafe, essentially done. I'm going to spend a lot of time trying to figure out what on earth I want to put on the wall. But this is cool, this is something we're going to be doing a lot more of. This was shown to me by Nith, not on purpose. Nith did their Inside the Books video that we highlighted on my workshop video last night. And I didn't know you could do this, but if you make a sign and you put the text on it, then you sync the sign into a wall, the sign will disappear, like not all the signs, but a lot of the signs will disappear, but the text will remain. So it's a really good way to have like bigger text in fonts that don't totally suck, like the default font on the alphabet decoration. It's a really good way to have those in the game without using actual signs. You can make your own giant sign, basically. So it's really cool. It's something we're going to use a lot more of. If there's going to be an indoor seating area here, I'm going to destroy all of those benches by the end. But doesn't the building look pretty cool? Like, I just say the basic fundamentals of the building, I think, look quite nice. It's a nice shape, it's interesting to look at, it just needs details now. And this was really the bit I was struggling with. How do I make the inside interesting? What do? How do we spice it up? I really like these are African sticks. I don't know what they're called. African logs, African whatever they're called. There's like 4 of them, African branches they might be called. There's like 4 of them, and they've got this like really cool, slightly modern look to them. You know, they are trees, but they're kind of bending and breaking and modern arty in a way. It's really cool. This, I think, it looks really good as well. Grabbing the wood, as I'm prone to doing. And basically, we're just going to cover one corner. It's like a statement corner. I'm not covering the whole thing. It is only... Ooh, I just punched my glass. It is only this corner that's going to get this treatment, but it just makes it look a little bit different, adds a little bit of intrigue to design of the building, and really that's what we're going for. We just want interesting buildings, and there you go. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? You take it home to meet your mum. Was desperately trying to figure out what I was going to do here. I am slightly addicted to the trees that we're going to bring in. I cannot remember what they're called. These boys, these ones right here. I love them. I really do. What are they? I cannot... Cypress? I have no idea. I love them. They're really cool because they have like really small versions and they are quite skinny, so they don't tend to like cross over into other things. They're just really good to kind of like have entrances. And yeah, these right here, these are African logs. We're going to use a couple of those at the side. So this is the only entrance that I would consider moderately done. I think it looks quite nice with the trees dropping down in size along the side and the bigger trees sort of opening it up on the left. It's quite a nice little funky looking little area. Still needs a bit of love, but who doesn't, folks? Who bloody doesn't? I wanted to put the bear in. I don't know where, but I want the bear. Decided against the fence as well. I think you decided against the fence. I don't like the fence. I'm looking at the fence. I'm hoping I get... Yeah, good job, best in slot. Get rid of it. So this is the bit when I was starting to really struggle to come up with a plan. So what I really started to do is A, put my music on, but B, I actually had another tab up on my second monitor and I was researching modern cafes and modern glass slash wood buildings more than anything else, modern glass wood buildings, and just seeing what other people, architects, bring into their work. And this one cafe I really liked did something like this. They had this big... It's kind of a wall, but it's kind of made up of these wooden slats, which coincidentally I'd already been using anyway. And they lit it up from the top and it looks really cool. And it kind of divides the shopping area, which is beyond there, with the seating area, but without going over the top. You know, it's not too much, it's not like a solid wall. It keeps things fairly open. You can see through it a little bit, but it's still also private, which I thought was a pretty cool combo. And the nice way to use my wood. Basically. likewise this, there's a lot of bars and cafes that I see do this where they've got like a floating glass ring above the bar and it'll light up and maybe you'll display some drinks in there and stuff like that. This bit does need a little bit of love and lighting, but that's just we started off at the very least. This is the only bit of the inside of the cafe that I would consider totally undone, this little bit shopping area. We're going to do a little bit of work here, but not enough. It needs a spark of detail, but I'm just adding a little bit of the metal. Again, we're just combining those familiar materials that we've been using all along. What I really wanted to do as well was divide the two shops, but we'll come back to that. We'll come back. Oh, we're gonna do it now. No, we're adding metal to the top of that. Just again, you want it to float a little bit, but not too much, you know, a little floater, not a big floater, but a little floater. This is going to be our menu board right here. So you'll see we'll be able to sync this into the wall when I pick a font eventually. Look at that, how good's that? I'm not sure I'm going to stick with the metal as a background. Gabagool, little reference, little pop culture reference there. So we're going to put the menu, it's going to be like inbuilt into the wall. What I might do is replace that with a plaster wall and make it black so it kind of looks like chalkboard. I think like a big chalkboard wall would be really cool. I'm just making a little rope metal thing. You know, just separate the two out, nothing too fancy. Might replace the rope with wood, but I kind of like the rope. A little bit of rope. Wanted to do something in this main area, so it's just going to be a little... The wall comes in a little bit. I don't really know why, but I actually think it looks kind of cool. It looks like a little bit of a feature. I was going to put water in it. It looks bizarre. I very quickly decided against that. And also these really stupid little hexagon planters, which again, ends up looking really stupid. Be gone with your hexagon planters, person slot. You're not wanted here. I think I ended up leaving it pretty much like it was. But the information sector and information bit needed a little love as well. So we're going to bring in some glass, we're going to bring in some metal, my big two favourites. And we're just going to put some plant life and foliage up there to give it a little hat. A little green hat is what we want, basically. And again, this is something I saw that other sort of modern cafes, modern glass wood buildings kind of did, so just got to take some inspiration from the real world. I do struggle a lot with coming up with these ideas. I don't really mind taking them from elsewhere as long as you add your own spin to them and you're not just... Yeah, even if you want to copy one-to-one, I don't really take issue with that. If you're copying from real life architects rather than Planet Zoo architects. I think that is actually a key difference for some reason in my head, but yeah, whatever. So bringing in those slats again, just trying to get them low enough so that you can always see the wall, basically. You can always see the trees and the plant life above that. And the idea was just to make you focus on the information bit, and then also kind of block off the staff wall over to the left. Really like these. Cool planters. Didn't want too much on there. I set my trees. God knows I love my trees. And these sticks are even cooler than the other sticks. There's so many cool sticks in this game. There's a lack of cool bushes, but there are a lot of cool sticks. Now, how long do we have left? Like 3 minutes, not bad. Don't know what I'm going to do for the next 3 minutes. The benches need to be sorted. Yep, doubling up on those. I shall see. I really wish you could control where you put benches. You can't, like, control X and move them along. You have to manually place them. It's a massive pain in the ass. Going to do a little bit of a plant pot section behind that wall there, because this area was lacking an intrigue, this little, you know, the shopping area back here, so I wanted to spruce that up at least a little bit. And look, there's my trees once more. The trees cannot be defeated. The trees have taken me now. I am one of them. I've become one with the trees. But because you can't see it from the other side, I think it's pretty cool. Bring in the sticks as well. Love the sticks. I think mainly what we're going to do now is work on, like, this kind of stuff. Just the outside of the thing. We're not going too hard on the foliage in general, just because it is very modern. It's a lot of pathing, a lot of building, a lot of wood, a lot of metal, a lot of glass. But it's nice to have some natural stuff in there. If you block off parts of the building, the whole thing kind of tends to look a little bit better. It creates more interesting sight lines. So it's always nice to bring in some big trees and mix things up just a little bit. All my foliage is North American. Tundra, tropical, taiga, whatever you want to call it, and grassland. Nothing else is used, basically. So at least it's consistent, but it gives us a nice variety of options. It was really annoying in my pen, right, only using Asian tropical. If it was only tropical, that'd be fine. If it was only Asian, that'd be fine. But so limited kind of annoyed me by the end, as much as I love the Asian tropical plant life. Just bringing in the same pathing, same fencing system as we did earlier on. Make a little garden there. Think that's near enough. It cannot possibly think what I did in this last little bit. I have just realized what I've done. So what you're seeing now, which isn't meant to be in the time lapse, I did, like, obviously my little poster video at the end where I talk and I go over what we've done and what we're going to do in the next video and stuff like that. We're going to take a much better look at the cafe if you want to see that slowed down. We're going to take a look at the exhibit, which has changed a little bit. We're going to take a look at everything. And I accidentally added it to my time lapse. So you're not meant to see this bit yet. We will stop the time lapse here. Hope you've enjoyed it. I will now talk at your face for another 10 minutes or so, you lucky sons of guns. Enjoy. There we have it, folks. Time lapse over. Lots and lots of work done today. Lots and lots of staring at the screen and not really knowing what to do, which made up about half the video. Don't tell anybody. So as I may have mentioned in the time lapse, I'm going to quickly show you what I've actually done since the last video as well. Not just the stuff you saw in the time lapse. I did do a little bit of work before then. A little bit of stuff on this section over there. Did a little work over here, just making this staff section a little, you know, just a little bit more natural. Down here we have a how you can help section where I've built like a educational display sort of shebang with the bees. Most importantly, I kind of want to change them all to the bees. Everyone knows the bees are most important, but you can see it's a bit of a disaster from behind. But from the front, it just looks like a educational display, which is very much what I was going for. I didn't really know what to do in that corner. That's fine. I really didn't need it to be anything huge or special. It just needed to be, this tree is too big. It just needed to be something more than anything. It just had to exist. I'm going to move that tree. I'm going to replace it with this cheeky little so-so. Bring him forward and rotate him a little bit. There we go. That's so much better. What else have I done? Yeah. If we hop over here, you'll see I have brought down the glass mountain cave cliff city thing. It's still fairly huge, especially on this right hand side, admittedly, but it is much less huge than it was. I think I sank it down by about a third, to the point where these middle bits are barely poking up. What I kind of want to do is maybe take off a little bit on this right-hand side, as we're going to do then. Maybe take a little bit more off this right-hand side, bring up that middle bit a little bit more, even it all out a little bit. I still like the idea of the middle bit dipping inwards and the sides kind of poof, pushing upwards, because I think that kind of is the opposite of what people expect, which I quite like. But yeah, so I might do that before the next episode. But other than that, I'm definitely happy with it. It was definitely a good idea to bring it down, so I really appreciate all the comments on that. Right, so moving on. I did a little bit of work up here. I don't know. Put another deer in there. Again, antelope. Not even an antelope, technically, but it's called a pronghorn antelope in the game. We're going to roll with antelope. Put another antelope just to separate this a little bit from the... whatchamacallit? The Ghost of Black Rock over there. And if we head down here, this area definitely needs a little bit of. We have everything we've done today. So we've got our... I'm sure I talked about this during the time lapse. I don't really want to go crazy into it, but we've got this thing. I don't know what it is, but I like it. We've got our tree displays here, a water display on the right hand side, little area, and then of course the cafe. So I'm going to try to not talk about this during the time lapse, but the cafe needs, it's come together, it really has, in a nice way. I think from there it looks kind of nice, you know. For me, I don't make this kind of thing at all. It's really not my speciality. So I'm really happy with the building shape. I really like the roof being in like two parts kind of thing. I think that's interesting. I think it is my best, one of my best buildings. It really is. And it's nothing special, don't get me wrong. But I think inside is actually coming along pretty. I'm pretty happy with the inside. I maybe want a little bit more personality in some spots. This area over here near the Gulpy and the Pizza Pen in particular. Also, there's a really annoying hole there. Wait, if I grab this and then we just shuffle this ever so slightly that way, can I fill that hole? Yeah, hole filled. This is going to be lit up eventually, and I'll do something up there as well, put a little display up there, and then I just need something in this little roped in area here, and I think the inside is done. I think it looks quite nice, it's quite pleasant looking, and interesting and modern, while still having some natural stuff in there as well. I'd like to bring in maybe one or two more natural touches as well, but we shall see. It is the outside where I'm having problems. I like this little entrance bit here, but it lacks personality. It needs like signs, it needs foliage. This side's okay because of the foliage there, but again, it needs more than just, you know, a perfect normal Planet Zoo doorway. It needs a little something to make it special, and I'm still not quite sure what that is at this point in time. So that is why I am stopping the video here, basically, so you guys can tell me. This wall in particular is deeply upsetting to me. Like, I just don't know what to do with it. I do want a sign. I need a name for the cafe. That's what I need help with more than anything. We need a name for the cafe, and what we'll do if we get a name is we'll make a big custom sign, and that's going to sit right there, and we'll do the text, and we'll do lettering, and we'll do like a little fancy modern design if we can come up with a cafe name. So I don't know why I had to say it like that, but I did, okay? Cafe Disco was my first thought. And get the, you know, get the music pumping, get the lights flashing, get a whole the office vibe going, but maybe not. And then maybe we'll do like a mini version of the sign over there on the left. And then I just need to figure out a way to make this glass a bit more interesting, maybe some other bits. But generally speaking, the whole thing is coming together really well. Yeah, I will say, I think this is my best zoo. I've got to say, like, it definitely isn't as expansive as some of the past ones, but in terms of the level of detail, in terms of pushing myself, in terms of the building designs and stuff like that, I realize these aren't super detailed. They're not like pirate ships, you know, we saw that video the other night. But for me, this is hard work. It really is. I've put blood, sweat and tears into this, especially the interior. I really like the interior, actually. It's just little things, you know, like these little bits here and this little bit here. That's going to look really cool when little, by the way. I'm going to put lights coming down from the top, like just underneath where the metal is. So like the beams will all light up individually. It's going to look really cool. Just little things like that. Little things like this hanging over there. It's just the little things that are going to bring this whole thing together. I just need to keep practicing on getting them done, basically. Bring in a few more natural materials and really meld them with the modern stuff. Now, I'm aware that this is a fairly huge time lapse for this video, so I don't want to keep you guys for too long. Next video, we will have our standard intro. What I'll do is I'll take your advice and I'll work on the cafe before the next video. I'll show you that at the start of the next video, and then we're going to work on something big. I also want to kind of redo this area here. This is, again, suffering from one of my problems, especially at the start of the zoo, the lack of stuff. It's just very dull. So what I want to build the next is the Science Museum. We do have more habitat animals, but I really want the Science Museum to be in this middle area here. And the idea is for it to be a big, half shattered looking glass dome thing. I don't really have a plan for it. All I know is that it sounds nearly impossible to build in my head, but I'm very excited to give it a go. And that's going to hold our exhibit animals. We're going to build some really cool stuff. The idea is you're going to walk forward, you're going to walk past the shops, and it's going to sit like bam, it's going to be the centerpiece right there. And then we've got more habitats for the wolves and the grizzly bears that we can do down the line as well. Okay, Black Rock Park. Coming together. Hope you enjoyed the time-lapse, hope you enjoyed the video. Please do hit the like button if so. It may be a few days now until the next episode. I know these aren't as quick as some people would like. There's obviously a lot going on at the moment with stuff. Can't actually carry on talking in that sentence. There's a lot going on right now, so let's put it that way. But, you know, this is something that's going to run over a very, very long period of time. The idea is to build a franchise zoo encompassing every single animal in the game, and then, as many people have already suggested, and was always the plan, to build, like, a master zoo, just one giant zoo with every single animal, with loads of different sections, kind of like what we did at the beta. Along the way, I'd like to do some unique zoos. We're going to do a Christmas zoo. At Christmas, we're going to do at least a Christmas exhibit, maybe a whole Christmas thing. We're going to build snowmen and Christmas trees, and we're going to have some fun with that. Yeah, that's about it, folks. So, thank you so much for joining me. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. We're looking for cafe names and also maybe some design ideas if you have any for these walls and, you know, the glass. I don't know, just general things that come to mind, but generally speaking, we're getting there. A name and like logo idea is the most important thing, I think, because I think if we get that on that wall, maybe do some detailing around here, that'll kind of bring the whole thing together. Anyway, I think this maybe needs some plants around it, and that will save that area. That's gonna make that a lot more. That's a good idea. We're gonna put some planters around there. That's gonna super help that whole thing. Very subtle, low to the ground, not big trees or anything. And then yeah, Science Museum. Big project, very exciting. Thank you so much for joining me and for all the incredible support throughout this entire series. I'm really glad that you guys have stuck with me and that you're enjoying it and you're having fun, hopefully. And I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.